Hello, machinist! The weather is getting warmer. It's a season for ice cream instead of dumping. Now, have you ever heard of regenerative energy? Regenerative means that something is revived. When an engine car is moving, it's trying to stop by stepping on the brake. In other words, when a car decelerates, the kinetic energy that was moving the car is converted to heat. Kinetic energy is lost as heat. The brake pads are pressed against the rotor when you step on the brake, and heat is generated due to friction. When I was in elementary school, I practiced sliding in the gym with my pants on, and it got so hot that part of my pants melted, leaving a hole. That was also frictional heat. By the way, is there any way to avoid losing this energy? Why not use energy without loss? So, let's regenerate it. This is why we are trying to revive kinetic energy that would normally be converted into thermal energy and use it as regenerative energy. When you step on the brake of a motor-driven car, EV or hybrid car, the deceleration mechanism is different from that of an engine-driven car. In a motor-driven car, the motor is also used for deceleration. Normally, a motor rotates by electricity, but it's possible to do the opposite. By rotating the shaft on the motor, electricity can be generated. So depending on how it's used, it can be an excellent generator. Now this mechanism used to utilize regenerative energy. When you step on the brake to stop the car is moving forward, so the tire is spinning at that time. The rotating force of the tires turns the motor, and when the motor turns, electricity is generated. In this way, kinetic energy is converted into electrical energy. These kinetic energies were converted into heat and released into the atmosphere in the engine car. Since it takes the power to turn the motor, this conversion of energy gradually reduces the force to rotate tires, and the car will stop. I refer to Toyota Motor Corporation website this time, and it seems that normally friction brakes are also used as support, because the force of decelerating by regenerative braking is not that large in practice. It's a good study for me. So the electric cost is improved, the cruising range extended by this technology. Yes, so far, this is a YouTube where we study automobile, is it? No. We are machine tool manufacturer. Yes, this mechanism is also used in machine tools. Today, machine tools are equipped with many motors, so there's a room for this regenerative energy to be used. I asked Panac about it, and they told me that they started implementing it about 36 years ago. That's amazing. In fact, this technology is quietly being used in our machine tool. Stopping from the movement of each axis in machine tool corresponding to stopping car. When machining, you repeat start and stop like this, right? According to Fanuc public information, conventionally, it's called the resistance regeneration method, and the energy decelerated by the motor end up being consumed by the resistance. Consuming it with resistance reduces the risk of high voltage on the inverter component, but releases it at heat energy. This energy is not consumed by resistance, but it's returned to the power supply as regenerative energy. This is called power supply regeneration. This allows the regenerative energy to be returned to the power supply and consumed as power for other equipment in the factory. So it's really making effective use of the energy to decelerate. Oops, here came a voice from various people. How effective is it after all? I think this is exactly the point we are interested in. So we did an experiment to find out. The result of the measurement on the sub-axis of the sub-movement system was the ratio of regenerative power to power consumption was 12.5 to 42.1%. In the form of 50 round travels of positioning with the G0, we also measured the spindle axis. The method of rotating the spindle at maximum speed and stopping it after 60 seconds, resulting in a regenerative power ratio 5% to 14.4%. So it can be utilized not only for axis movement, but also for rotational movement. It's likely that this kind of effect will gradually accumulate with each axis movement, which will ultimately reduce the power consumption. Compared to normal machines, multitasking machines tend to have more stop and start in axis travel and rotation system. Therefore, the effect is likely to be greater when compared to a system that does not reuse energy. In an experiment by Fanek, using a machine center, the average power consumption was reduced by about 35%, according to the description on their website. As described above, the use of regenerative energy is actually very interesting technology that is active behind the machine too. From the viewpoint of energy conservation, and with the rising of cost of electricity, we often hear people say that they still want to reduce power consumption more and more. We would like to continue to understand the technology and solve these issues through technology. Thank you for watching today. If you like this video, please click the good button and subscribe to our channel. See you soon, machinist. Bye.